Hello, John Talley here with PartZilla.com, and look what we have here. It's a 2008 Yamaha R6 motor. Now, where's the rest of the machine? Well, it really doesn't exist because we actually bought this used, and I'm going to go through the process of completely pulling it apart. Now, what's that going to involve? Well, involving pulling the head off, checking the cylinders, then actually splitting the crankcase, and then putting it all back together, replacing any parts that may be worn out or damaged. Because honestly, we know nothing about this engine, so that's why we're going to pull it down. So if you're ready, I'll go grab my toolbox and we'll get started. All right, guys, before we get started, a few things we need to go over. This is actually going to be a skill level 3, so you need to bring your A game. This is going to be pretty intense. I mean, it's not just tearing apart the motor. You need to do it in an organized fashion. Need to label everything, need to put it in Ziploc bags, because when it comes time to put it back together, that's when it's really going to pay off. So what tools are you going to need to pull this off? Not really that intense. Yamaha keeps it down to a minimum. As far as sockets, you just need to make sure you've got a basic range from 8 up to about 19, except for this guy. It's a 36 millimeter, so you're going to have to go pick up one of those. Other than that, need to have a few Allens, a 5, a 6, and an 8. Other than that, just an oil filter wrench. And most importantly, you want to make sure you have a T30, because there's a couple of bolts on the output shaft of the transmission. They're not Allen's. They're going to be this little star configuration. It's called a Torx. So we want to make sure you have one of those. Other than that, just a decent ratchet, a few different extensions, pick tool, magnet really comes in handy, 10 millimeter wrench, and you're also going to need a mark saw. Other than that, a couple of pairs of pliers, what I call a soft blow hammer, and then just a flat blade screwdriver. Like I said, plenty of Ziploc bags to keep all this stuff organized. One other tool that I do want to mention is all the diagrams that we have available at PartZilla.com. They basically give you a layout of what you're trying to accomplish. Shows how it goes together, and that'll make it a lot easier to take it apart and then put it back together later. So check those out as we go along. It'll make a lot more sense to you. So if you're ready, let's get started. All right, guys. I don't know if this thing was shipped with oil in it or not. It's not supposed to be, but let's go ahead and pop the drain plug and see if there's anything left in here. Plus, if it does have any oil in there, I want to look at the condition of it when it comes out, because that'll give me an indication as to whether or not there is a problem. All right, well, it looks like the shipping company did what they were supposed to do, so there's no oil in here, which is a good thing. So we can go ahead and proceed forward. All right, step one, let's go ahead and get this valve cover off. Then we're going to pull this cover right here, and that actually has the timing marks to where we can bring the motor around to top dead center. And as I've said probably 100 times, I love using these little impact tools to pull things apart, but do not use them to put things back together. You will be sorry if you do. But it does make quick work of sections like this. Another thing we're going to need to go ahead and do is there are going to be a whole lot of nuts and bolts involved on this teardown. So it all seems real simple right now, but I guarantee you when you've got everything spread all over God's creation, you're not going to remember where it all goes. So we need to go ahead and get some of our Ziploc bags and start tagging each section that we pull apart, starting with the valve cover. Just kind of make a mental note where each one of these little brackets are. If not, you'll have to come back and rewatch the video to see where they went. And that's actually called the pickup rotor cover. There she comes. And there's your pickup right there. All right, we're getting ready to bring it around to top dead center, but the spark plugs are still in it, so let's go ahead and get those pulled. That way it'll be much easier to turn it over. Looks like this one was burning pretty clean. All those look good, nice and even. All right, we're going to bring it around to top dead center, and there's two things that we're going to look for. One, this mark right here is going to line up where the crankcase meets together. You can't really see it, but I can. That little line is right there. The other thing that's going to signify it being at top dead center on the compression stroke is that the camshaft lobes are going to be facing up. So let's bring that around, turning it clockwise. All right, well, that's set to top dead center. Let's go ahead and start getting those cams out. And that begins by getting the tensioner off. Now we can go ahead and take off the caps. And if you'll notice, they've got each one of them already labeled for you, either on the intake or the exhaust side. What we want to do is kind of bring it off in a sequence, kind of keeping them level, because we don't want to create too much of a bind and potentially break one of the camshafts, because these things are extremely hard, but that also makes them very brittle. So we need to be careful of that. So this section out toward the end, where it's just a single point, we can go ahead and take those all the way off, because there's no pressure on either side of that particular bearing surface. And they also, if you look carefully, have little arrows that face toward the gear side, so it makes it more difficult to actually, you know, end up doing it backwards or something like that. So kudos for Yamaha on all those points. All right, initial impressions. This motor looks to be in pretty good shape so far. And all the cam surfaces, the lobes, and then the bearing surfaces, if you want to call them that, all look really clean. So when they said this was about an 8,000 mile engine, I believe it. But we're going to still go all the way through it. All right, when you're removing the head bolts, of course there's a certain sequence that you need to go through, and we want to do this a half a turn at a time until they get loose. And I've got them marked just on the top of the head. And it's the same for the tightening. We're going to do a half a turn on each one. Before we let the head off, I'm going to go ahead and take out the chain guides. Not too bad. That actually looks really, really good on the 2 and 3. You can still see all the crosshatch on the hone in the bore. All right, but let's go take a look at the head. What I'd looked at earlier were the conditions of the valves, or at least the stems. I mean, we're going to break the head all the way down, because like I said, we're going to take it to a place called Star Racing, where they're going to do a multi-angle valve job, as well as massage the ports just a little bit. All right, we are actually going to have a bunch of head work done on this, like I said, but I still like to have things go back to the same position they were in when they were taken out. So these tappets or buckets, they will be reused. So I want to go ahead and number those so I can at least get them, you know, back in the same position. And is my shims going to change? Well, yeah, chances are all of them are going to have to be redone. But I still want the bucket carriers or the shim carriers to end up in the same bore that they came out of. So I'm going to go ahead and number those. And since they are pretty much just loose in there now, let's go ahead and take them out. See, the shim, the actual shim itself is still in the bucket. All right, let's go ahead and get the clutch cover off and then take the clutch apart itself. Need to get that dipstick out of the way as it catches on that bottom edge. All right, there we go. As you're removing these, kind of want to make a crisscross pattern. Loosen them up just a little bit at a time. All right, that's got most of the pressure off, so we can go ahead and take them all out. All right, guys, when you're pulling these apart, at the very bottom there's an oval-shaped washer, so you want to make sure you don't lose any of those, because I actually dropped one while I was doing this. While we're on this side, let's go ahead and put the clutch pack out. All right, let's get the main bolt off for that clutch basket. Got our holder in place. All right, we've got the clutch pack out of it, but to actually get the basket out, we need to get the chain off, which is actually down at the oil pump. So the water pump needs to come off, then I need to put, yeah, I guess you call it the oil pan, get it removed, then we can remove the chain, and then this entire section can come off. And once you get those two main bolts on the front of the pump housing, then you've got a couple of hose clamps left around the front of the engine, and the whole assembly will come right off. Yeah, as you're doing this, they hid one right down in there. So don't forget that one. The oil pan usually tells the tale, because you can drain the oil, but that doesn't get you to everything. The oil pan, if it's got a bunch of sludge in it, that'll tell you that it hasn't been maintained very well at all. This one, it doesn't get much better than this. I mean, that is pretty much perfect. There's no sludge anywhere. So this engine was in really good shape, making me feel good the further we go. All right, well, our oil pan off, when you can go ahead and get to the oil pump itself. Get this oil tube out and get these, looks like three 10 millimeter bolts that hold the oil pump in. As well as this little pickup tube. Now with the dowels out, you can shift it over, tilt it over a little bit, and then kick the chain off. And then out comes your pump. All right, before you can get the clutch basket to release, you have to rotate the crank to where it clears that counterbalance and the connector rod. Once you've done that, then she can lift out. And there was our oil pump chain. Go ahead and lift out these roller bearings and these different washers. Make sure you keep them all together, because it's gonna be very important that they go back in the right order. So you got that small one, flat, this, and then the roller bearing. All right, let's go and get the starter off. Okay, the starter just has a couple of 8 millimeters on it. All right, now let's bring it up, get the stator off. All right, let's get this cracked cover off, which we're not gonna reuse. Several 5 millimeters all the way around. Careful, don't let the magnets pinch your fingers here. There she is. Let's go ahead and get this intermediate gear out. All right, we're removing they call it an oil cooler, little inside tip here. If you're rebuilding a clutch that had completely failed, in other words, all the fiber had come off the disc or been burned off the plates themselves, you want to open this up and flush it out, because basically there's a bunch of little passages in here, and if they get gummed up, it's going to starve the engine for oil. I've seen it happen. And the guy replaced his clutch, put it back together, didn't clean this out, and it fried the engine. So just a little inside knowledge there. All right, let's go and get the pickup coil here. But we'll also get the timing chain out of the way. And rotate it up, put a support through here, disconnect this lower bracket for the engine, and then we're gonna pull out all these bolts, a quarter turn at a time, and we're going to split the cases. As you will see on this diagram, there are a bunch of bolts we have to take out a quarter turn at a time. So if you would reference this diagram and follow me around as we get these things loosened up. Number one, right there. So let's go. All right, well, they're all basically loose now, so it's time to go ahead and zip them out. There she is. Right, initial inspection, all the gears look great. I don't see any teeth missing, anything like that, irregular wear, all looks really good. The bearing surfaces, at least on the mains, looks good. So let's go ahead and get one of those pistons out and take a look at it. All right, a couple of 10 millimeters to get this end cap off. About a quarter turn each. All right, a little bit of wear, nothing substantial. All the surfaces look good, and the pistons are actually in fantastic shape. But I want to let y'all in on a little secret. These are easily reusable. I'm not going to reuse them. It seems that the guys over at Wisco heard about our little project, and they decided they wanted to get involved. So they are sending us one of their 636 kits. So what are we going to do? We're going to tear this down all the way, actually send off the block, have it bored, then we have to have it replated, then we're going to put it all back together. When you're pulling these out, you might want to take note that it had numbers on this side of the connector rods. That'll give you a reference point back toward the transmission as to which way they go. All right, guys, as I'm taking this apart, I'm actually going to number each one of the bearings. But I plan on using these or reusing these same bearings. Yeah, the cylinders are actually in fantastic shape. Still see the crosshatch, but that's not going to matter now, is it? All right, let's get that shift shaft out of there. Starts by pulling off the circlip. Rotate it up so y'all can see what I'm doing a little bit. It's about as far as I can go. All right, just want to release the spring. And all of that comes out together. There's also a washer on this side, so make sure you keep up with it. All right, looks like we've got a couple of plates that are holding our shift drum cassette and then our main gears, and that'll just about be it. Careful, there's a spring here on the back side of this plate. Go ahead and unbolt that main shaft. This one is a T30. All right, to remove this, what they call a main axle, need to get a couple of 6 millimeter bolts. And they actually screw in here and here, act as a puller. Just keep going back and forth evenly. Now the bolts you're doing this with, make sure they're not used anywhere on the engine itself, because you know it's kind of destroying the threads at the very end. There we go. So these were just a couple I had laying around. Well, all right, guys, there you have it. One 2008 Yamaha R6 torn all the way down to the crankshaft. So what's next? Well, like I said, we're going to send off the head to Star Racing and get it modified. We're going to send off the block, get it bored, get it ready for those Wisco pistons, which is going to punch it up to a 636. Going to be nice. Well, listen, if you need to reference any of the diagrams, why don't you find us online, take a look at those. Kind of get an idea, a visual idea of how all this stuff comes apart, and more importantly, how it's going to go back together. Speaking of that, if you want to watch me put this back together, why don't you follow us over to the next video. And until then, we just want to say thanks for watching.